because if you did have a freedom of economic choice of what to do with your own money, how best to allocate and manage your own resources,
man.
Government wouldn't threaten to send you to another cage if you didn't pay your taxes, right?
That's true.
Right.
Yeah.
So that's how government is more. This organization only knows how to solve problems then through one way, a singular way, and that's through the threat of and use of violence to solve any problems versus the plurality of nonviolent solutions that you and I already share.
That's true.
Right?
But can I tell you a quote?
Please, please.
The tree of liberty must be refreshed from time to time with the blood of patriots and tyrants.
Whoa.
So, Thomas Jefferson.
Yeah. I mean, Thomas Jefferson owned slaves, so you can't really say that he was for liberty of equality for all people then, right? It seems like it was, at your sacrifice. You don't see Thomas Jefferson fighting with the bayonet out there, right? So it's your children who has to do the fighting for him, right? Politicians always say that. You don't see them in the front lines.
No, you don't. They're the fortunate sons.
No.
Well, right on, man.
Yeah. So awesome. I guess what do you think of I guess the argument?
I like it. I mean, no, I obviously nonviolence.
Right.
You know, but no, that's real cool. I'd like to get become a part of whatever you're doing. That's a good,
Yeah, man.
Because I have I'm from Northern Virginia, but
Me too.
Yeah. So it's definitely definitely share those beliefs. I was in the Libertarian Club when I was in high school.
Oh, yeah? Yeah, the perfect. So, have you ever heard of the term anarcho-capitalist?
Yeah,
all right. So, I'm an anarcho-capitalist. So, government has monopolized all the services that I want, like law, security, roads.
Yeah.
I want these services to be provided in a free market competition, right? Where you won't have the dilapidated quality of, depreciation of quality that is so exhibited in these government monopolies. That's pretty cool. So, Liberate RV is a non-political organization. So, we're trying to go outside of politics and government and trying to propel the non-aggression principle.
Yeah.
Out here in our community.
Right on, man. Well, it was a pleasure.
You
thank
too.
You.
My name is Cal.
I'm Sean.
Sean, well, let me give you some pamphlets then, man.
Yeah, for sure. Right?
You have no freedom of economic choice. You still have to give me your money. You still have to give up your property. You still have to pay your taxes. Because if you did have a freedom of economic choice and how best to spend your own money, how best to allocate your own resources, government wouldn't threaten to send you into another cage if you didn't pay your taxes.
Well, okay, see, the only thing is, in that respect, I feel like there are certain things that individuals cannot do. Like national parks, preservation of all of those things. Because otherwise companies are literally just going to go ahead and chop down literally everything. So I think government regulation in that sense is okay.
All right, we could talk about that.
Okay.
We could talk about that. That's a good point to bring up. But so this organization, though, as we can see then, only knows how to solve problems, though, at gunpoint, through the threat of and use of violence versus through the plurality of nonviolent solutions that you and I already share.
Right.
So this concern about what about the parks, what about the environment, right? So let's look towards an organization, a government. If they don't even value human life, then what makes you think that they care about the environment? You know who the largest polluter of the planet is?
Us.
Yeah, the United States government, the military,
obviously.
Right? So I would say, if we want to do take care about these parks and the environment, then the last organization we would want to seek help from is the largest polluter on the planet.
Okay, you mean in a general sense.
Right.
I think I was thinking of just the specific, branch of government. But if you're talking about overall, then you're right. Government in that sense does... All they ever do is just shoot you if you don't listen.
Right. Now, here's a way how you can protect those areas, right? So government doesn't have respect for private property, right? For example, they don't even provide security. The Supreme Court has ruled many times that the police have no obligation to provide you security. No obligation, no duty. So now you imagine you're being forced not to pay for a service in which they don't have to provide. So there's no respect for private property. So given that, of course, you're going to have a lot of people just polluting and just getting away with soiling the land because the government doesn't recognize your ownership of the river, for example, right?
Okay.
Only government owns the river, and they'll just fine people when they feel like it. Whereas if you own that portion of the river, you can take them to a court that does respect private property, and they can be sued, right?
Okay.
You can have insurance contracts that says, hey, I don't want pollution in this region. And then you'll find those insurance contracts will kind of pass out this kind of clause in many of the communities surrounding it. So in the event that one polluting agency wants to move in there, they'll buy out the land and sell it to someone that's not a polluting agency, right? So there's a lot of ways to preserve the land. If there's a market for it, right?
Okay.
If there's a demand for having parks, then people will provide that, right?
Right.
Let the entrepreneurs figure that out, right? Start a Kickstarter campaign.
Yeah, of course.
All right. so we can find nonviolent solutions.
Right.
We don't have to point guns at each other, to taxes, to steal from each other to fund it. And in regards to a lot of the parks, though, there's a lot of, I've come across a lot of interesting schemes that a lot of people would do, knowing that the government will turn it into a public park and no one can build on it. So what they will do is they'll buy a property and then donate, make maybe 90% of it to the government, declare a national park, but because they have that property, now they have like prime real estate right next to the national parks.
Okay.
And now who protects the parks for them? The government, right? At your expense.
There's always money behind
right?
it. That's what I didn't realize.
Right?
There's always money.
Right, so for their enjoyment, they have this national vista protected by government that no one can move in there, no one can develop or get in there.
Right.
But for their enjoyment at your expense, right?
Yeah,
so,
about it that way.
Right.
All right, man, thanks.
Yeah, man. Well, so that's how government is. This organization only knows how to solve problems the one way, a singular way, then, and that's through the threat of and use of violence to solve any problems, versus the plurality of nonviolent solutions that you and I already share.
Okay.
So what are your thoughts on that?
I mean, I completely agree.
Yeah.
It makes a lot of sense, yeah.
Right?
I mean, you're forced to taxes.
Yeah.
You're forced to comply.
Right.
If you haven't seen the videos online where just people getting beat for not complying.
Right.
People get shot, get killed.
Right. Yeah, especially everything getting shot. So like even the Constitution, the Supreme Court has ruled in many cases that police have no obligation to protect you. No constitutional duty to protect your life, your freedom, or your property.
Yeah, I saw a video of a man being beat because he refused to show his ID and he was in a passenger seat. He wasn't
right?
Driving.
Yeah, he wasn't even driving.
So he got peppered. They broke the window.
Right.
They pepper sprayed him in front of his kids and they beat him. For no reason. Just because he didn't want to show his ID. He wasn't even driving.
You know what? Probably will end up happening to that cop. He'll probably be reprimanded. He'll probably move into administrative duty, shuffle him around, but he won't get fired, right? If like an employee at Wendy's, you know, slapped their customers around like that, get fired immediately, or they get sued, or they get bankrupt, you know, they're out of business. But this government monopoly and security, they can't get bankrupt. They have no liability, right? And that's so much you can't sue a judge, right? Total immunity from their own actions, right?
Yeah.
So and that's what you have in these government monopolies. They're not held liable for their own actions, right? But in the private sense, you are, right?
Yeah.
You can't even sue a state prosecutor, for example, right? So the alternative here, what this table is about, we advocate for a free market society that's consensual, that's voluntary, right? Again, there exists no factual evidence that you can show me a contractual relationship with government, right? Show me your contract with the police services, right? Show me your contract with any of the government service. Doesn't exist,
yeah.
Right? And that's almost like USPS has a monopoly on first-class mail delivering pieces of paper. Whenever you have a government monopoly, cost goes up and quality depreciates. So when people say, how do you feel about the rise in stamp costs? So that, not like you have a choice, not like there's any other mail service you can go to.
Yeah.
Right? It's illegal and criminal for FedEx, UPS, and DHL to compete in that market. They can't deliver a piece of paper, they can only deliver packages.
So there's force.
Right, and every time you have a government monopoly, costs, quality depreciates. That's why USPS are $16 billion in debt. They're threatening to cut off Saturdays. And the way how they resolve long wait lines is by removing the clocks. So you don't
One
know
thing
how long you've been
I do not
for.
Like in banking, there is a regulation called Regulation D.
What's
and
that?
You can't transfer between your savings and your checking more than six times if not the feds will find you.
Oh my God, yeah. I guess there's also one is like you can't do trash transactions or deposits that's more than $10,000. You know, that's I guess a red flag. And that's forcing these banks to comply.
One thing I do not like either is what happened to my brother, being that he has to pay so much back in taxes because he makes a certain amount,
right,
that he couldn't keep up with the payments. And they froze his account. The IRS froze his account.
Right.
And he was forced to call them and to work something out.
Oh, yeah.
His accounts. In order to access his money.
Right.
He couldn't withdraw anything. They would have kept it all.
No, yeah, that is blatant theft.
Yeah.
I'm trying to remember, like there's Hardy Breweries. Have you ever been there yet?
No.
They went to the city council here in Richmond and said, hey, listen, are you sure that beer is not a meal? Because, you know, so we pay the taxes. City council say, absolutely, it's not a meal tax.
Yeah.
A year later, last year, they came to them and said, actually, you owe us a year's worth of taxes. We decided arbitrarily that beer is a meal, so you owe us like $40,000 in taxes, right?
Okay.
And that could have been money that to hire a new employee, to lower prices, to expand, improve quality. But that goes back to the government, whose only function is not to create anything, but really to steal everyone's value, everyone's, their wealth, right?
Yeah.
The government doesn't create any wealth. Everything they give away was taken from someone else, right? Well, that's cool. Yeah, I guess you have a good, what are you studying here at BCU?
Homeland Security.
What are your thoughts on Homeland Security?
It was something I was forced on, by my parents. So.
Right.
So something I'm just trying to finish up, but I don't have any plans on pursuing it.
Right. No, it's get the degree. There's a lot of different, I guess, grad
opportunities.
Yeah.
I want to get into more more business.
Right? Yeah. Yeah, I think there's a lot of big market for that. Yeah. I mean, and that's the message the government will try to control that. But like trying to provide real security, that's an interesting market niche. Like in Detroit, it takes over an hour for the police to respond to 911 calls. Right, unfunded liabilities, things collapse and depreciate. But there's this guy who's providing real security, Viper threat management systems. Is that an area that you're interested in, like providing security, or what kind of a?
No, I'm actually one. I want to do completely the opposite.
The opposite.
I want to get into financial advising.
Right.
I was just like kind of.
All right, cool. Well,
pressure to do what I'm doing right now, but I'm not gonna get a job in it.
Right.
One thing I don't like is the Patriot Act.
The Patriot Act, right? Yeah, they can. Yeah.
You read up on all that.
Right. Time. Same thing with the National Defense Authorization Act. Every other act is one like, piece of
very
your freedom
invasive.
Taken away.
Yeah. Very invasive. You know?
Yeah. And that's the organization of government, right? If we found out that like Wendy's had this kind of program or some others, like they get, you know, they go bankrupt immediately, right? There's a backlash. There'll be a boycott. You know, you would be able to choose other businesses that do value, I guess, your freedom of
one
privacy.
Thing I don't like is I know a gentleman who owns a business, and they were the city, they went to his business and they didn't like the way he put something, like his AC unit.
Mm-hmm.
And they would fine him if he didn't move it. But so he wanted to move it and he had to get a license, and in order to get that license, he had to pay some taxes that he owed.
Oh my God.
So if he didn't pay those taxes, he would be forced to be shut down.
Right. That's ransom.
He was really upset.
Yeah, that is blatant ransom. Yeah. Right? But they can't call it that. They have to call it by a different name, otherwise people won't go along with it.
Yeah, man.
That's messed up, man. well, you come to the right place. We have a lot of good economists in our organization. We're a non-political organization, so nothing but politics. We see a lot of the evil and a lot of the ways that they hurt people. It doesn't improve their lives at all. So what we're aiming for is a free market society then, right? Entrepreneurial society. And let me give you some pamphlets that I think you might be interested in.
Okay.